All right, fellow pilots, drivers, VR simmers, if it's your first time here, I want to say welcome. Thank you for joining me. Today's video, it's going to be a one-year analysis of the HP Reverb G2. I've had it now since November 14th, 2020. And I was just checking on Steam. On Steam, I have almost 1,500 hours in VR, which I don't know if that's a lot or a little. Let me know in the comments below how many you have in Steam VR. But I do a lot of DCS and Microsoft Flight Sim and a few other games that don't do VR, especially Vorpex, right? That don't count any hours. So I'm probably thinking I have twice or three times that many hours because I probably spend the least amount of time in Steam VR as of lately, but most of my time is in the other sims. Anyways, guys, I digress. We're going to continue here. I'm going to be giving you my experience, my feedback, the pros and cons on this headset, why I recommend it here at the end of 2021, and why I still think it's going to be a beast here in 2022, which is kind of crazy to say, but guys, stick around if you want some more information, my review, my thoughts on this headset. We'll get into it right now. Here we go. So guys, before we continue on that, let me talk about one thing. The Reverb G2 V2 is here. And guys, this actually improves on a lot of the things that the G2 needed, which the G2 improved on a lot of the things that the G1 needed. So if you guys are curious on how this compares, expect that video to come out a little bit later. I still haven't even opened it. Now, another thing is we're going to talk about the face mask, right? This is the VR Covers face mask. This is a 3D printed face mask. I'm gonna have the Reverb G2 face mask and the Reverb G2 V2 face mask, which is part of the reason why, you know, it makes that headset so much better. It's kind of hard to see here, but one is more narrow than the other. And anyways, guys, expect that video coming up. If you guys, you know, want that or have any questions about the improvements on the G2 V2, let me know. But let's get into this review here of this one-year analysis. So guys, I started doing a little bit of research on the Reverb G2 and its launch, and I went back to my unboxing video 1 year ago. First of all, the video is terrible mic, audio, lighting, everything, and not that this is any better, but it's a little bit better. The one thing I learned from that video was that we had a really rough launch, right? When you look at the comments in there, people are saying, hey, you know, it's been a rough launch, I can't get a hold of one. And it's not because HP did a bad job, it's more because of the demand was so high for the G2. Because the G1, the HP Reverb G1, was such a good headset, people were looking forward to the integrated audio, which is an absolutely amazing solution with this headset. You know, them working with Valve and just having this headset, guys, you know, the audio was just a really key feature. So that was one of those things that kind of really, you know, challenged them. Another thing was the controllers, right? People were talking about controller tracking and how was that a bit of an issue, and was it an issue? For me, it wasn't, you know, but I know some people lost a little bit of tracking in certain situations. But really, I'm just going to share with you why I love the Reverb G2 and why I think it's a beast headset. All right, guys, so let's really go into the pros and cons of this headset. The first thing, it's a little pro tip right here. I do have a zip tie, which you're going to see right here. It's plugged. It's not plugged in. It's connected pretty tight. And this zip tie is preventing this headset from pulling out, because in the G1, this was a fixed cable. It was heavy, very obnoxious. This is a cable that's detachable. That's why people have been able to upgrade. By the way, if you have a Reverb G2 with the original cable box, with the original cable in the cable box, and you're having issues, contact HP support, see if they can replace that for you under warranty. In most cases, they've been able to. If not, I think it's around $75-$80. I'm not sure. It's definitely solved a lot of issues, and for those that are able to get it under warranty, I definitely recommend you do so. But as we continue, guys, the tracking on here, it's done with four cameras inside out tracking, right? So it's one on each side, so I guess two right, and then two on the front. And I've had no issues with this. In fact, a lot of times when I see people say, hey, I have issues with the tracking, it's turning, you know, it's going weird, it's glitching, the big things I recommend is, you know, have good lighting. I have really good lighting in this room. In fact, I have some other lamps on the other side, but the lighting is key for this tracking to work well. So the inside out tracking, it's an awesome feature for me, because you can take your laptop, you can take your headset, and you don't need base stations. And base stations are a little bit clunky, they're frustrating, you have to set them up. You normally need more than one to have a good experience, because the base stations track the IR emitters, I believe, on the headset and help you locate your position in space in the room. So I love the inside out tracking. At the bottom right here, we do have the IPD adjustment, which is a manual feature. So I'll show you real fast if I can without breaking this. There we go. IPD adjustment, it's manual. Now, guys, if you guys know, the Vario Aero has an automatic IPD adjustment, which hopefully I pick one up in this next year. You know, I'm really trying to see if I can either connect with them or get one of those headsets, bring it onto the channel for review. But this has a manual IPD adjustment. A lot of headsets normally have a digital IPD adjustment, which is going to be a little bit simpler and not as efficient, in my opinion. So I think we already covered it, but if I didn't mention it, the audio, right? This audio solution here, it's amazing, guys. It's off the ears. It really is. I mean, you see my head, it's not going to touch my ears. And the thing that people say, they're like, oh, that feels weird, I'm going to hear sounds, this and that. The best part about having these off-ear headphones is the fact that you're even more immersed because you're not wearing headphones, and the sound, it just feels natural, as if it's in the environment around you, as if the sound, as if you're in the room and you hear either the bullets or you hear the engine of the car or you hear the reverse thrusters of the airplane. You know, that's what makes this sound. It's not touching you. It just, you feel like, okay, so when you're in your car, you don't wear headphones, you know, and listen to the engine of your car. You don't, you know, wear headphones and run around, you know, playing paintball, I guess, if that makes sense. But my whole point is, since it's not touching you, it just adds an extra level of immersion. The downside is you're gonna also hear ambient noise. So, and I'll tell you what, I max out my 3090 and all the fans on my computer. I max them out and I don't hear them, really. I don't hear them over, you know, the sound of the plane, the flaps and everything else. So I have no issue with my computer running loud, and it's really not loud. I'm not one of those people that complain about it, but the audio solution here, it's amazing. The combination and the work that they did with Valve was really good. So now let's talk about the resolution, guys. The resolution on this headset is 2160 by 2160. Now up top over here, I have an Oculus Quest DK1, which the resolution on that per eye is 640 by 800. And it's not all about the resolution. It's not, but it definitely plays a key factor into this. You know, the Fresnel lenses, by the way, it's Fresnel. It's not Fresnel, like I've been saying. Some of you guys got really mad that I said Fresnel and I got some nasty comments. So the Fresnel lenses that we see in here with those funny rings will kind of distort the image. It's just not the best. That's why, again, the Vario Aero, although expensive, it has the aspheric lenses. It's what they use in cameras, and it just gives you that smooth, clear glass without those rings. The 2160 by 2160 resolution on here, it's amazing. I mean, coming up from the DK1, I had the DK2, the Oculus Quest 1. I had the Rift S, the Oculus Quest, the Oculus Quest 2, the Lenovo Explore. I've had so many headsets, really. You know, when I had the G1, I was just blown away. And coming to the G2, you know, it kept the same panel, right? The 2160 by 2160, but it just gave you all the comforts. It gave you the improved head strap, which, although not perfect, it's a big improvement. You know, this could be a little bit better right here. And I think one of their, the Omnicept Edition, I forgot who had, I don't know if it was Steve or someone else had in a video. The Omnicept Edition is just, it's better. It actually fixes that. And there's some third-party solutions that do fix that. But the resolution, guys, on here, it's just amazing. It's the key thing. I'm sorry I'm talking about it so long, but it's why I really love this headset. All right, so another thing is these controllers, they actually work pretty good. You know, I'll be honest with you guys, whether I've been in X-Plane, you know, controlling the overhead panel on the Zeebo 737, or if I've been right here playing Pavlov in my little play space, I've been really good. I mean, I have not had any issues. And let me not lie to you, I've had a handful of issues. It's been, gosh, I don't even know how to say it. Like, it's not even 2%. It's not even 1%. It's kind of like, I don't know. Nothing here in VR works perfectly. And I'll tell you what, this is no exception, but I have not had issues in here to the degree that folks are mentioning, hey, you know, it's terrible. For the most part, this headset with this controller, which it's light, it's good, it feels comfortable in your hand. It's a really good solution. Might not be perfect, might not be as accurate as having base stations, and that is a fact, but this is still a really, really good solution, and I cannot knock HP for it. Any improvement that we get on this, I'll gladly take. You know, and I think the biggest issue with the controllers was the integration with Steam and having WMR, and then, you know, just some of the software issue on their end, but as far as tracking, it's been absolutely amazing. And actually, Microsoft Flight Sim just got VR controller support. And I haven't put out a video on that yet, just because it's still kind of funky. But I also did see a video using Leap Motion for VR tracking, hand tracking. And I'm going to do a video on that a little bit later. I'm super excited about that, just because it seemed relatively good and accurate with the controlling with using your hands. And if I can get that to work, I'll bring a video. If not, you guys get to save some money and not do what I did, which is buy that. Now, finally, the best part about this headset is, guys, the price. Right now, you're able to get the G2 V2 for as low as $450. Microsoft had a sale on it. Right now, I think it might bump back up to $500 once they sell like a certain lot for $450. I'm not sure. Again, if I have any links, I'll definitely link them below, but keep an eye out for that as the holiday season is coming up. We have Thanksgiving here in the United States. If you don't celebrate that, you still get to enjoy Black Friday around the world. So just keep an eye out for any deals with these headsets. Anything really below $600, it's an amazing price. If you can grab them for $500, for $550, for $450, this is a steal of a headset. It really is, because you guys are actually going to get the Reverb G2 V2, which is awesome. And another thing to consider, guys, if you find one of these headsets used and you can snag one for $400, $450, or maybe a little bit lower if you don't have controllers with it because you don't need them, and you're able to test the headset, guys, go for it. You know, I mean, honestly, that's how I got my Reverb G1, and it was a great headset. It really did me, you know, a lot of good times, a lot of good flights there in VR until I went to the G2. Guys, I know this video is getting a little long, but if you do find any value in this video, I just want to say, click that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up button. But anyways, guys, I want to thank you so much, really. And just, you know, don't forget to subscribe. Let me know. Give me some feedback in the comments below because it helps me make better content for you guys. All right, guys, now that we got that out of the way, I kind of feel always weird asking you guys to subscribe and hit the thumbs up button. But, you know, it does help out. It really does. So thank you. Let's talk about some of the negative stuff here. Number one, the speakers. They're amazing, but also one of the downside is, which I guess it's good, right? So they're detachable right here. They have these little screws on both sides, and something about my right speaker got a little funky after some time, and I had to just touching it like this would literally make the sound flicker. But once I tightened the screw, it really solved the issue. So take a look at that, guys. If you do have that issue, just tighten that screw. Do not over tighten it. Do not strip it, and use the right screwdriver. Do not get one from your garage, you know, that's massive. You're going to definitely need a PC toolkit, a small one to work on here, and anything computer related. If you have that issue, guys, it's so frustrating. You're flying and then all of a sudden you hear ATC in your left ear and you hear static in your right. And it really breaks the immersion, right? So that was a downside. Now, this solution right here, right, guys? The reason I have this right here, it's because this actually, first of all, with the Reverb G1, this was fixed and you couldn't do anything about it. Now, my Reverb G1 did pretty good. In fact, I sold it to a buddy. I think it's been doing well for him. In fact, I have to ask him. The G1 was fixed. This one allows you to detach this, which is really neat. Now, if you do that, guys, please be careful. Any active power running to this headset, plugging this headset in and out, could either brick the headset, brick the little box that goes to this. I don't know. I would just say use extreme caution. So again, right, anything electrical that you're plugging in and out is just not a good idea as it's powered up. So if you have to unplug it, make sure your PC is off, make sure there's no power, and then unplug it when you're going to do that. I just smacked the mic. So again, my solution is having this fixed here because this headset was getting loose and I was losing my image. You know, this was actually just a few weeks ago. So I had to kind of like fix that connection, tighten it up again. And that's just something that you have to be aware of. You want a snug fit. Don't let it wobble loose. Be careful. Use extra caution when you're putting it over your head, when you're wearing it, right? So that's just something you have to be aware of. So guys, I will say this. This is actually not the same headset I picked up 1 year ago. In fact, this is a replacement unit that I got sent from HP. So it's a good and bad thing. The bad thing is my left eye went out on the headset, and the good thing is HP was able to replace it, and they did it in a relatively fast time. So their customer service was great here in the United States. And in fact, I got the G2 cable, the updated cable, right? And I was also able to get the updated or a replacement headset because the left panel had a bunch of vertical lines. I mean, literally, I was flying one night. I hung it up right back there where the Quest 2 is. That's where it goes. Normally, the Quest 2 is over here. So I hung it up, turned off everything like I do every single night when I'm done flying. Come back the next day and I'm like, you know, let me go for a quick flight. And the left eye had vertical lines on it. And it was, you know, you couldn't avoid it. You couldn't miss it. It was almost not quite dead pixels, but it was just awful. It really was. So I contacted them back and forth, a couple emails. They sent me a box. I sent mine out. They sent me one back and this is it. So they sent me a new faceplate. These were covered with a blue film on it. Honestly, it didn't have any fingerprints. It looked brand new. At least this was brand new. I'm also not sure if I noticed some vertical lines now when I look in the headset. I don't know if it's just me, if I'm being picky. I mean, I do honestly have hundreds of hours in this headset, if not way more. And And I'm not just sure if it's just me or if I hadn't noticed it before, but once I open the G2 V2, I'll let you know, give you some feedback. But again, the headset, it's amazing. It's still working amazing. It's still working really, really good. I noticed somebody else in one of the forums that said, hey, listen, I got like these vertical lines. And I don't know if it was just me trying to like look for something wrong with it, thinking, oh, it's a refurb unit, something's wrong with it. But I kind of could have sworn I saw it. Like, I feel like if I'm looking really hard for it, I see something. It's almost like a slight difference on vertical pixels. It's so subtle, guys. I'm telling you, I have to look really hard for it. In fact, I forget it's there 99.99% of the time. So it's probably me just being nitpicky about it. So honestly, those have been the biggest downsides on this headset. And I'm not going to lie, this has been a lot of work trying to fight this cable here. So I have this contraption up here. Let me show you. It's a pulley system. It's amazing. It's $30. I think I told you about it before already. I'm forgetting. But it's pulling the headset away from me, so my arm's kind of tired. And so actually with that pulley system, if I didn't say this before, it just feels like your headset is free floating and like you have a wireless headset on. That's why that cable is like that. Because when it's right up here on your head, the cable is like a zero G status. It's just floating. It's just neutral. It's not pulling up and it's not pulling down like the G1. The G1 cable was so heavy, it would just like tug you like this off your left side the whole time, you know? So I used to like Velcro it up against the wall so the headset wouldn't pull me down with that big old cable. Guys, overall, this is an amazing headset. It really is for the price here as we approach 2022. I've had some amazing flights in VR. It's the quality of the headset, I think, has been great. It hasn't been perfect. I know some of you guys have had a lot of issues. Some like me, and I see a lot of issues. Maybe I'm exaggerating, you know, as we have a Facebook group for VR, I do see a lot more people complain often than not. You know, people normally, if their experience has been good with VR or with a headset or with equipment, whether it goes for the Quest 2, the G2 or anything, normally people are quiet. They're pretty, you know, low key. They're just flying around having fun. But the moment an issue pops up, you know, those are going to be the more vocal, post, you're going to see people saying, hey, this is broken, this is broken, this is broken, while you have a lot of people in the background who are enjoying their flights and so forth. So again, I don't want to discredit those people. I just want to, you know, bring you a balanced review on this headset. I think it's absolutely worth it. I think HP so far has done a good job with their warranty, with helping out with fixing any issues, and I'm grateful for that. I think it's a one-year warranty. I'm not sure. I didn't pay for anything extra. So again, guys, we'll end the video here. I'm going to bring you the content for this new Reverb G2 V2 headset coming up. On top of that, I'm going to have a 12900K RTX 3090 12th gen build video on that monster PC right back here. So expect that video coming up. And also, I plan to do a little tour of my whole VR sim pit here and how I kind of put it together. And I'm sure some of you guys are interested on that. So expect that here coming up in the next few weeks. And also, if you guys are here in the United States, happy Thanksgiving. And if not, enjoy Black Friday around the world, Cyber Monday, whatever it is. Look out for those good deals. And I'm going to put some links below. They might be affiliate links. They might not be. If I can figure it out, I'll put them there for you guys. Either way, to help you guys. Thanks so much. Be well. Peace out.